today's session is not a lecture, nor it is a hands-on workshop, actually. This is a session for all of us to learn from each other. And as a facilitator, I'm here to learn from you all, meritorious fellows, from your experience in the field of TEL, which stands for Technology Enhanced Learning. Moreover, my personal role in today's session be more towards letting you have metacognition, which means you'll be inclined towards knowing what you already know. So to begin with, technology enhanced learning, or in short, as we will be continuously calling it as a TEL, is any technology that enhances the learning experience. This term can be used to describe, both analog and digital technologies, but more recently, and particularly in the field of health professionals' education, we see that digital TEL, not analog TEL, the digital TEL is taking over education in the form of different types of educational apps, software and devices, tools, and so on. So actually, TEL is transforming and enhancing education and educational institutions beyond recognition. That's why I must say that as an entity, TEL is impossible to be ignored. This is especially true given the very growing prevalence of educational apps, softwares for teachers as well as for the learners. We are now entering in a phase of education, by the way, it is at the national level as well as at the global level. So we are entering at a phase of education where technology is not just a valuable resource or an option, no. But it's an essential tool helping to improve the experience for both learners as well as the educationists. So they both have become more aware now, or we can say they all are well informed, or these days usually we call them tech savvy than ever before. And much of their day is spent, interacting with some form of technology through mobiles or internet packages or whatever. So undoubtedly, there is a general consensus among the healthcare stakeholders about the benefits of TEL. To name a few, we can say there is an exponential rise of remote and hybrid learning, which we just have witnessed, during the pandemic time, through which learners had really gained knowledge at their own pace. And also not to forget that this particular technology is providing multiple teaching and learning resources, which generally keep you guys and educationists like myself more engaged. So much so that now we have to request sometimes to our students or kids at home even to even stop using their smart gadgets. So this notion has been built, or this impulse has been generated, that technology is necessary. And we all believe that, okay, yes, we have to go with it if you want to succeed in this contemporary time. So although there could be a very extensive debate on this topic about its pros and cons. So well, let's get back to our this session. So as you all are now ready to get started with it. So, okay. During our today's session, I have to just remind you again that I will try to keep terminology as much as simple as possible, because I believe we are here to learn about TEL and its basic concepts, its basic elements, the categories, its impact on educational institutes, and so on. And we believe that few among us might not be much affluent with pure terminologies. So I'll try to avoid using the pure terminology, but as I just have mentioned earlier, as analog and digital technology. So just to let you know that when we say digital technology, it's like a technology that has translation of information in binary format, 0 or 1, like computers, CDs, DVDs, or other examples of digital signals receiving and sending devices. And whereas analog, we don't have much care about analog because we'll not deal with it in today's session. But just to give you a basic concept, that analog technology is being used like we have devices like FM radio, we have devices, light sensors, and we have devices for GPS all these things, they use impulses, actually, electrical impulses, no? So that's why we call them analog. So anyway, so let's move on with today's presentation. Actually, it is obviously all about TEL, but our main focus would be around main aspects related to technology enhanced learning in terms of the background, so that we may get familiarized with what actually is the TEL. And we shall have some flavor of the current state of work in regards to TEL. For example, its main elements, implications, its usage for distance and online education. And last but not least, we'll also discuss and enumerate and look into the tools which are available to be utilized for teaching and learning in general and for online and distance learning in particular. Okay, and how about a quick quiz for all of you? Let's check this out in the next slide, because we are in a session that is being organized for your course and that your fellowship. So, and by the way, to make our session more interesting, we shall have few MCQs, very basic MCQs that would be considered as part of your formative assessment. So, and you'll be giving ample time to make very small, brief, tiny presentation towards the end of today's session. And I'll give you later on some more details as how you are going to make your presentation and how you're going to present your presentation and what we would require and what would be we expect from your presentation. So don't worry much about it. That will you'll be giving ample details about it later on when the time arrives. So again, just to remind myself and just to get a kind of bridging contact between you guys, you fellows, and myself as a presenter, as a facilitator, we have to set some rules or principles that are known as objectives, so that you should all kind of keep focusing on these particular objectives. And these are SMART objectives. So, and why we call them SMART objectives, I think now you people have got all your fellowship and few of your lectures already been done. So you should know that when objectives are like, SMART, they have to be specific, they have to be measurable, they have to be attainable, they have to be realistic, and last but not least, time-bound.
Time-based.
So we are going to describe what TEL is. And same time, we will be able, after getting in touch with each other throughout this session, how we have to recognize commonly used TEL tools. And same time, we all shall be able to classify and differentiate between various components related with TEL. And we shall all be able to demonstrate steps of utilization for the tools and for the resources that are like apps and tools and whatever. And last but not least, appraising and assessment for the impacts of TEL on educational environment is also one of our objectives in today's session. So I would like you guys to write your answers in the chat box. I think you all must be aware to use the chat box. And if somebody is not aware, he or she can just, unmute yourself and tell your answers once others have given their answers in the chat box. So it's a simple, very simple, basic set of MCQs. As number one is asking that TEL, technology enhanced learning, is an emerging educational domain. So if you agree, you can say yes. If you don't, you can say no. If you are still in doubt, there's an option for you as a not sure. And same options are for the question number two, which is asking you that TEL is a new educational domain. And third MCQ for you guys as a startup is, have you ever used TEL for your teaching or learning? So I think we'll be given 1 minute time for all of you to put your replies, your answers in the chat box. And I think the moderator would be able to look at the chat box. And if everybody has written down their answers, nobody's remaining, then we will move on. I think still answers are being poured in. Yes, it's best way to write number one, then answer, then number two, then answer, then number three, then answer. Oh, you people have done so far so good. Okay.
सर हम बहुत टेक्नोलॉजिकली एडवांस हो गए.
मैं तो ये देख रहा हूँ कि मैं ख्याल में गलत ग्रुप ऑफ स्टूडेंट के साथ आज जो है ना वो सिंगड़ा बैठा हूँ. ये तो माशाल्लाह ऑलरेडी वी आर वेरी अडेप्ट सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम हैप्पी रियली गुड. ओके सो गाइस आई एम हैप्पी टू सी योर आंसर्स. Basically, there were no right and no wrong answers, but actually, it is an emerging educational domain. Yes, and it's a new educational domain. No, and we will let you know in preceding slides that this concept is like you know quite ancient, older than my age or even my grandfather's age. So, and for number three, yes, you have ever used technology learning tool. So, I think most of you have. Done yes for the three. Now I'm basically very happy to see this yes in question number three. And there is a very rational logic behind it. Because I am now dealing with guys who are like, you know, very meritorious. So alhamdulillah, this is something good. Now let's move on to knowing about the main players in today's session. So we should just get some glimpse of what we will be just, you know, keep talking about. So basically TEL, which can be defined as the implementation of technology into teaching as well as learning, is a very common occurrence for today's student. And one area of specialized education strongly influenced by this technology development is health professional education. So before we take any action, we are here defining our main players and like medicine, mental well-being, and last but not least, TEL itself. So as a result, as the time has been, you know, having a very fast pace in terms of developing a new emerging tools. So as a result, these all disciplines are now, you know, at the forefront of the implementation of what you call it cutting edge technology into their curriculum. And we all have to just, you know, keep a pace with it. I firmly believe that most of us will not deny about the importance of three main questions whenever we are talking, dealing, learning, or teaching any concept. And these three questions are what, why, and how. And they are, these questions, if been answered, always help you, you know, to explore about what particular topic you are in, you are dealing with. And once you get the answer to these questions, it's going to enable you and me as well to be more engaged and to show more initiative and really have a greater understanding of our world. So let's together know from the next slides that is how getting the answer to these questions would lead us towards our aim for today's session. Over the last century, various new technologies were introduced in education, in the field of education. Often, educational revolutions were proclaimed. Unfortunately, most of these new technologies really, really failed to meet high expectations. Excuse me. It is not easy to identify a starting point in the history of learning technologies. Maybe ancient cavemen were the very first or primitive user of this technology, where they have just started working with chemically extracted color pigments for arrangement of their painting and lessons, all these things. So what basically is TEL? It is the implementation of technology into teaching methods or learning methods to enhance the learning process and facilitate students getting their objectives. Why is it important? The teaching activity has changed with the internet or devices such as computers, smartphones, tablets. So we all believe now that it's really possible now to use even other forms of education and different means of learning, which are amalgamed with the technology and letting this all, what does it all do? This all process lets us have focus on education actually. And without teamwork, it is impossible. So one point has to be remembered, that technology enhanced learning has to be a teamwork as well. Individual can also, you know, excel in this field, but when he has to impart, because here we are talking TEL in the context of teaching and learning. So while we are teaching, we have to teach someone. While we are learning, we have to be taught by someone, right? So, and how to achieve all this? So we know that TEL is growing very fast in today's world. The new schools and the new medical schools, institutions, colleges, all their supplies are now technological. And that is valued in the classroom by the students as well. So let's explore some examples of it, like tools, resources, systems, apps, new models for teaching, frameworks, and so on. And we know that digital textbooks have replaced paper textbooks. So paper books are heavy, or now at least been considered heavy, which we used to carry without making any complaints in the past. And it is now uncomfortable to transport these heavy books daily in your backpacks. And furthermore, with the continuous advances, discoveries, and frenetic pace of events, they soon become outdated. For simulation, medical simulation really allows the acquisition of clinical skills and learning skills in many institutes now through deliberate practice rather than an apprentice style of learning. So it has got benefits as well, like, you know, simulation tools serve as an alternative to real patient, and a trainee can make mistakes and learn from those mistakes without the fear of harming the patient. This is the basic, most important advantage of using simulation for clinical skills. And then comes LMS, as a learning management systems. For example, we call them Blackboard, and there are many other names for LMS. What do they do? They keep students engaged with the provision of teaching, learning, as well as for the feedback. Anyone among us would try to search on internet for artificial intelligence driven technology, or TEL, and they can be called as synonyms. So whenever we try to get these technology tools on internet, there is a variety beyond our imagination. You can try and explore yourself whenever you like. But like any other technology, this particular domain also has its pros and cons. So being smart enough to choose the right smart tool is mandatory. And this is a basic rule, basic principle for everyone who is trying to play with technology. So you have to be smart enough to choose the right smart tool, and it's mandatory. And why it's mandatory? Soon you are going to know in our preceding slides. So let's have a break time. We will be having a few breaks here and there, just not to get you bored. I know that you guys have taken your 1 hour length break earlier, but still I think if you want to grab and go and grab a cup of tea or water, like, which you can manage in 1 or 2 minutes. So is there anyone who can just realize and recognize what is being shown on the screen now? Which area is it? In Pakistan, outside Pakistan? Or if it is in Pakistan, where is this? Basically, these all three images are from one particular place. You can unmute yourself. You can unmute yourself, and you can tell if you want or if you know. Sir, any guess?
Dr. Zubaida batayengi. Unhone bahut zyada posting
kiya hai. Let's hear from her.
Zubaida.
Any guess? There are no marks, by the way. There are no marks of grading or scores for this particular quiz here.
The second
this is just
picture,
to agree, yeah? Refresh.
Pakistan,
sir. Very loose. Sorry, one place
is saying. One place is saying at different times, from different angles and, you know, different places. Chale, main aapki help kar dun. Aapko thoda sa, should I tell you which province? Is this
taken from? सर के पी जी।
अच्छा ये कौन, हिमायतुल्ला साहब ने?
जी सर
वो हर चीज केपी के लिए।
ओके सो नॉट टू बी
बायस्ड,
हुंजाए गिलगित है। हु इज दिस स्पीकिंग?
डॉक्टर सारिया।
सारिया, डॉक्टर सारिया। ओके टू आंसर्स, एनी मोर? अभी आप लोग जो है ना, मैं चलो आई शुड गिव यू अ हिंट दैट इट्स नॉट इन द प्रोविंस ऑफ केपीके और इवन नॉट फ्रॉम नॉर्दर्न एरियाज। अच्छा चले जी, मैं आपको बताता हूँ, ये प्रोविंस सिंस है। अनबिलीवेबल इज़न्ट इट?
पोर्ट मुंडू नहीं, सिंध में नहीं।
पोर्ट मुंडू
नहीं, सिंध में नहीं
जनाब, ये है सिंध में और इसको हम कहते हैं गोरख हिल स्टेशन। लेटर ऑन यू कैन जस्ट यू गाइस ट्राई टू एक्सप्लोर दिस एंड आई वुड रिकमेंड यू टू स्पेंड सम टाइम देयर। It's worth visiting place. Actually, it is situated at very high elevation of more than 5,000 feet. Exactly, it is 5,689 feet. Or it's in Kirthar mountain range, 58 miles, or you can say 94 kilometers from Dadu city. Or it's a pretty special climate, ji. And the temperature goes sub zero.
Hello.
जी तो ये था
हमारा दादू, तो गर्म इलाका है ये। हाँ तो बहुत
गर्म इलाका है जी, ये दादू से आगे हिली एरिया है और इसकी एलिवेशन जो है ना वो इतनी है 5,000 से ज्यादा, 5,000 फीट से ज्यादा, तो इट गिव्स इट अ स्पेशल क्लाइमेट एक्चुअली। Or temperature is sub-zero during winter, and generally below 20 degree, it remains there like, you know, 17, 15, 14 degree, even in summer. So you guys have to just give it a try whenever you will have time, and definitely you will gonna enjoy, inshallah.
Okay, thanks for informing, sir. ऐसे ही सर एक इलाका भी है फोर्ट मोनरू, अगर आप साउथ पंजाब से उधर जाते हैं
यहाँ से लोग स्मगल करके कंबल,
तो वो हाईएस्ट स्टील ब्रिज है और पता नहीं कितनी ऊंचाई पे, उधर भी बर्फ पड़ती है और काफी ये एक वो भी नई एक
जगह है,
वो डीजी
नहीं होना चाहिए, जाना चाहिए और ये जरूरी है। ये हम लोग जो है टेक्नोलॉजी में अपने आप को जो है ना आगे से आगे लेके जा रहे हैं और ये हमें पता नहीं कि हमारे अपने सिटीज में और जो है ना,
हाँ जी,
और यहाँ पे इतने फॉरेनर्स आते हैं आप जाए तो, यू नो। तो thank you Dr. Salman for your input, thank you very much.
Welcome,
so
sir.
Getting back into the business, so we know you know there has been evolution and from the ancient times, and there has been like, you know, so much changes. We started earlier with mechanization, which represented industrial production based on machines, and they were powered by water and steam and so on. Then time came for electrification that has required mass production of using assembly lines. Basically this electrification means the process of making a neutral body into a charged body. Whereas automation that has arrived in 70s, so automation was about using electronics and computers. Then we have seen this time, and we are still being passing through this time, that is known as digitalization. And this, everybody knows that it involves the introduction and usage of connected devices through Wi-Fi signals and data analytics and AI technology, what we call it, artificial intelligence technology, is being as a part of it that lets have an automotive process being further developed. So future is being predicted for now, personalization. What would be emerging, only God knows, but with our anticipation, with our assumption, we can say that the personalization will definitely focus on cooperation between man and machine. As human intelligence works in harmony with cognitive computing these days, by putting human back into industrial production with a collaborative robot leading to mass customization and personalization to customers. It sounds scary as well, anyway, but this is what future being predicted in terms of technology.
काफी जगहों पे तो सर इम्प्लीमेंट भी हो रहा है, सॉरी आपकी बात करता हूँ, लाइक जैसे अमेजोन स्टोर है कि सेल्फ चेकआउट, आप मोबाइल के अंदर, मोबाइल से ही आप ऐप करके अंदर जाते हैं और बाहर आते हैं, आपने चीजें उठानी है बाहर आएंगे, नो कॉन्टेक्ट विद एनी वन, और एग्जैक्टली आपके फोन से वो पैसे कट हो जाएंगे. इसी तरह रोबोटिक्स भी काफी जगह पे है जिसमें वो सर्व करते हैं होटल्स में, और इस तरह तो शुरू तो हो चुका है.
They started serving us on, and there's been so much, like, you know, now this industry, the name of biotechnology, and we see that the robots are now in replacing humans while performing very complicated surgeries. So, and this all has to just, you know, come in next slide. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, current literature, what we have in hand today is full of actually evidence. No, हदसे ज़्यादा उसमें हमारे पास जो है ना वो ample evidence that learners are experiencing and developing burnout. It doesn't really have to do anything so far what has been discussed, TEL, but as we have earlier start in our starting part of today's discussion, we said that there are many main players in this field. So medical students are also main players, and they are being burned out. And to lessen or to reduce the extent or severity of various mental well-being issues, it's important to look for the resources that might be helpful and impactful in reducing the stress and burnout, and also to have well-balanced mindset among all these various resources which we already possess and use. So to reduce the extent or severity of various mental well-being issues, it's again very essential. It's essential to look for resources that are available, then that they can help us in reducing all the stress and burnout issues, and also to have a balance, as we already have spoken. So after you have completely integrated your smartphones into your lifestyle, that everybody is having har koi apne haath mein jeb mein, you know, all the time apne reach mein access mein rakhta hai. So now in this lifestyle that has received, and we know that many of our people whom we are known to and people who we know are having pacemakers in their bodies and new hip joints, new knee joints being replaced, and LASIK vision that improves vision, and a few other technological implants also. So you might consider yourself a bit changed now, you know, with all these things around you and your relationship with technology and your new self. You know, when we have become, like, you know, part of this, your technology has become part of us. So it has really made us feel a changed person in our own self. So how do you put it all into perspective? Like, you know, we know human intelligence has got, like, you know, being spoken and taught in institutes like 4 C's, capital C's, alphabet C's, are very important while defining human intelligence, like capacity, competence, commitment, and creativity. But we all have to know at the same time that regarding IQ, which is known that human intelligence is a mental quality that consists of abilities to learn from your experience and to adapt to new situations and to understand and handle abstract concepts, like, you know, very complex concepts around us, and use knowledge to manipulate one's environment. And undoubtedly, I mean, bilashak intelligence is the dynamic interplay of engagement and ability in pursuit of personal goals. Whereas EQ is the emotion quotient which drives self-awareness. It helps in managing emotions. It nurtures self-motivation. It helps in carrying out and play around with actions that deal with empathy, and also plays a vital role in handling relationships. Whereas SQ, which is known as spiritual quotient, is again the ability to recognize your personal life principles that build one's life in accordance with human values and laws, in other words. So spiritual quotient refers to an ability to assess our deepest meanings, values, and what to say, purposes and motivations as well. So We believe the spiritual quotient is therefore the intelligence required to ask most fundamental basic questions in life and seek answers to them. And questions like, you know, who am I, where am I, what is going to happen afterwards, and many more. Now ask yourself, is it that now a new you, a brand new you is emerging? And in this emerging new you, composed of, is it just composed of just flesh and blood, or has been like, you know, silicon replaced, carbon as part of your technophysiology? So we have to think that how can we consider things like IQ and EQ in the context of the techno-evolved human? In fact, it's been argued that we may already need to expand IQ into broader perspective, which can include BQ as well. You know, BQ, body quotient. And then emerging one is MQ also, moral quotient, just to better capture today's reality in your own self. We may later in some other, I think, session, some other dedicated session may deal with BQ and MQ. But today we try to find in ourselves how our, my or your new you or my new me require a new Q. What this new Q could be? Techno quotient. If this is a high time for me and you as a new you, then definitely it's also high time for a new Q as well. Why not? So maybe technology needs to be more empathetic, but perhaps we should just start thinking other way around and, like, you know, in a curious way, that it might just be humanity also that needs to be more empathetic towards technology. So I don't think there's a mushy middle here. That's why we say that a bland compromise that obscures and doesn't resolve, and it keeps on going on. So I'm fine with defining our humanity by IQ, and I think that EQ is great too. It's great too. But maybe it's time for a new Q, and this time technology demanding a seat at the table. So while introducing TQ, which is technology quotient, and that represents a personal ability to adopt and to integrate technology as compared to the a statistical norm or average for our age, taken as 100 or maybe so on. So if we are able to connect the ties in our daily life or routine work, and by the way, our routine work, you know, roams around our professional workplace as well, or rather most of our hours in any given day are spent in an environment which requires us to have a mind which is nourished with all required quotients, and especially as the technology is emerging all around us. So we must equip ourselves with the TQ as well, that is technology quotient. So ties need to be connected in today's time more than ever. Let's see what WHO has to contribute. Contemporary society, like, you know, today's world, if you see, just, you know, if you look around in our neighborhood, at our home, while we are spending time with our friends, or even in the classroom, in the lecture hall. So contemporary time is somehow happy and satisfied to see the new generation being involved, or rather as we see them being immersed in the digital world, and sometimes, you know, being called with various names. Sometimes we call them digital native, tech savvy, sometimes we call it net generation. And the caretakers, who could be parents like me, or even the teachers, they might or might not seem to be worried. Some of us, not everyone, they are not much worried about the actual health of their child, of their learners, their student. So this all predicts what? This all really predicts a need of balance between various aspects of students' health, be it psychological, social, mental well-being, physical well-being, everything. So actually, why we are so concerned about having a balance? So we have to get this answer. And we have to know that what is going to happen if we are not having the balance. So that we are now going to share. So as we all know that, and we all read every time we hear from our seniors very often that, beta, it's never too late. Beta, it's never too late. Beta, it's never too late. Okay, it's never too late. Okay, I also believe it's never too late to make things right or to start right things right away. But in reality, it's always good to start working before it's too late. So when we say it's never too late, doesn't mean that we have to just keep waiting, keep lagging till the damage been done. So, you know, otherwise, what could be the consequence? Let's check this out. So if we have a balanced mindset, this is what we have. If we have all the cues, you know, all quotients are aligned within a balanced mindset. And this is going to happen, like, you know, robots will be also giving surgeons a helping hand. So we can see the TQ, IQ, EQ, SQ all are being aligned, being in place. But at the same time, we have to see what happens. This is what happens. And this is reality, what happened. The left hand side, you can see, is an example of consequences of not having not having the balanced mindset for all ties together is not a small thing. So now choice lies with us, actually, as to which side of such a particular image as we are having it now on our screen we wish ourselves to be on. So that's why balance needs all cues to be aligned. Excuse me. Now, if you check out on PubMed, which is a database or search engine, and what I have done just earlier this morning, I just typed three words: technology enhanced learning. And to my surprise, it's very clear that the concept of TEL is not new. I knew it. And also, it's not very uncommon. There's plenty of research is already been done. So in this slide, as you see that what happened, when I put the filter from years 2000 to 2023, I think anybody who has done any research course or any work was done with your help as a student or as a doctor, as a researcher for publication, you all know what PubMed does. If you just put filters, it gives you filtered results. So when I put the filter for the years from 2000 to 2023, I got 12,926 results with only this terminology used in the search box: technology enhanced learning. So much so already being published. And you know what? When I put a more strict filter, like, you know, for the last year only, I put it like 2022 to 2023. So now PubMed has to give me the results from 2022 to 2023. That was again 5,373. I think Dr. Salman has raised hand.
Sorry, sir. अच्छा ये जो आपने दिखाया सर ये 13 साल की रिसर्च आप बता रहे हैं.
Exactly.
ठीक. अच्छा उसमें वो 20 लिखा गया था ना, इसलिए मैं कंफ्यूज हो गया. ओके सो
जी हां. Is a typo.
पहले मतलब के 13 साल में 12,000
as you can see, yes, you can see on the PubMed page, the filter on the left hand side, the graph, like, you know, it's a kind of graph going from 2000 to 2023. And when I just filter it out again to make to you know, gain the knowledge that what has been published in the last year only, particularly in the last year,
50% से भी ज़्यादा एक साल के अंदर.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, astonishing. It's astonishing. At the same time, on the left hand side, Salman, you and others, you can see on the left hand side there are journals with the name of technology, and they're publishing so much research every day. So yeah, if we are not we are not getting to know this particular concept that we are, like, you know, discussing right now with all you guys here, so probably we'll be lag behind. So that's why it also just, you know, gives you the significance of today's session. So let's move on to see that I tried to check that when it was, I mean, the first time I couldn't get it exact idea because on PubMed, some results were different, and on the, the other databases like Medscape and like Science Direct and, you know, Web of Science, I tried to find it, but exact date was not mentioned. But I could check very ancient time article written in 1975, and that was in the Journal of Nurse Outlook, and they have just, you know, they really touched this particular topic of TEL actually, and that was published in 1975, maybe before the, you know, birth of many of you people. So and that was an overview actually, and it has discussed various aspects of TEL. If somebody is interested later on, you can just, you know, get to know through these articles. The advantage of using audiovisual instructional techniques were also being dealt in this particular article for the nurses. It was noted also for administrative strategies for encouraging the effective use of educational technology. And all these details were provided. So these days, actually, in our current times now, among us, I don't know, or I don't, you know, assume there would be anybody living without mobiles. At the same time, among us who are not familiar with Google Forms these days, I think either we are regularly being creating Google Forms to get collection of the data from our samples, our subjects, our students, or if we are not creating ourselves this Google Form, at least we have been requested, or you might have been, I think, already experiencing to being requested by your other colleagues, your seniors, to fill out online Google Forms. And Google Forms, actually, it is a survey administration software included as a part of free. It's free and free web-based Google Docs. And there's a Docs editor suite being offered by Google. And this service also includes Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Drawings, Google Slides, Google Sites, and Google Keep. So Google Forms is only available these days as a web application. And I guess that most of us know it. And even if somebody may say, oh man, no, I don't use mobiles. I've never been in touch with Google Forms and never have used Google Forms and so on. So at least we can show them this particular old machine, or probably if it is very old for you guys. So maybe this one. Okay. So at least these people who deny having mobiles or deny knowing Google Forms, they cannot deny that at least they might have seen these old machines or these new computer sets in whenever they visit banks or any corporate offices. So means every one of us in some way, to some extent, being touched, being, you know, coming in contact with these machines. So it is very, it's very obvious. So now again, we have, because every 10 slides I have keep a break for 1 or 2 minutes to refresh ourselves so that you should not get bored. So now again, kaun batayega bhai? Pehle to ye to bata denge Pakistan mein hai ki is outside Pakistan. First question. Then we'll jump on to next question about its location.
Sir, ye Pakistan.
Sir, Pakistan nahi lag raha.
इसमें पाइन ट्री उसमें अजीब ट्रीज मुख्तलिफ से
गलतहार के पास इस तरह की लेक्स हैं लेकिन उधर ये
एक है नील वहां लेकिन पता नहीं ये वो है कि नहीं कलर वो ही है नील वहां वाली लेक
भाई पहले तो ये आप डिसाइड कर रहे हैं कि इज इट पाकिस्तान और आउटसाइड देन वी विल जंप ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पाकिस्तान में है या नहीं
शायद
सब पाकिस्तान
लगतों से लग रहा है आउटसाइड है वैसे इस तरह की लेक मैंने देखी हुई है कलर का
मुझे नील वहां लग रही है
अच्छा भाई है पाकिस्तान में दिस वाज अ बिग एंड और मैं आपको या तो प्रोविंस बताऊं और यू कैन मेक योर जजमेंट
प्रोविंस बट
आई वांट मी टू गिव यू द प्रोविंस यू गाइस आर लाइक यू नो सो यंग एंड नॉट बीइंग यू नो काइंड ऑफ ट्रैवलिंग एनीवेयर भाई जाया करें कि सारा दिन टेक्नोलॉजी में इमर्स्ड हो गए
पढ़ाई में जॉब में फंसे रहते हैं सर
सर घर वाले नहीं जाने देते
घर वाले नहीं जाने देते सलमान साहब पढ़ पढ़ के थक गए चश्मा लग गया तो सब कुछ लग जाते तो दिस इज एक्चुअली इन बलूचिस्तान
बलूचिस्तान लोग जा रहे हैं सर पहले तो लोग नहीं जाते थे अब काफी टूरिज्म खुला लोग जा रहे हैं
जबरदस्त जगह है और
हनालेक
नहीं हनालेक तो नहीं दैट इज वेरी डिफरेंट वो तो दैट्स वेरी डिफरेंट और ये हनालेक से थोड़ा दूर है, ये बोलान में है, बोलान वैली अगर आपने सुनी हो, इट्स लाइक इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग मे बी 65-70 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम क्वेटा। और वो वहां पे जनाब जो कैस्केड्स है ना वाटरफॉल के, वाटरफॉल पूरा कैस्केड होके नीचे आता है रॉकी माउंटेन्स में, तो साइड मेकिंग करता है, इट वाज थ्रू यू नो मेनी स्ट्रीम्स एंड पॉन्ड्स अमंग द शेडी पाम ट्रीज, ये एक्चुअली पाम ट्रीज है तो पाकिस्तान में बड़े कॉमन होते हैं और बहुत जगहों पे, खैरपुर में तो पूरा है वो डेट्स जो है ना फार्म्स वहाँ पे बहुत है, सिंध का इलाका है खैरपुर। तो एनीवे दीज आर पाम ट्रीज एंड अच्छा इसको कहते हैं वो अजीब सा नाम है, सो आई डिडंट वांट टू मेंशन इट, कहते हैं पीर गायब वाटरफॉल्स और उसको कहते हैं पीर गायब वाटरफॉल्स, ये बड़ा मशहूर है। सो इफ यू कैन जस्ट सर्च लेटर ऑन प्रोबेबली यू विल गेट टू नो अबाउट इट्स एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन, बट आई कुड रिकॉल इट्स लाइक यू नो 65 और 70 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम क्वेटा, इट इज सिचुएटेड इन बोलान वैली, सो इट्स अ मस्ट गो प्लेस, इट्स अ मस्ट गो प्लेस। हाँ maybe later on when you guys have time and when Salman will get some time from his study, so he have to refresh himself. So the Salman agar aap jayenge na to ghumne phirne to udhar padhai pe zyada acha dhyan lagega aur padhai achhi productivity hogi inshallah, right? So Waalaikum Salaam.
Hello, I mean Dr. Rehana baat kar rahi hu, aapne technology se related mobile ki baat ki na, मैं हूँ एक्चुअली रोबोटिक सर्जन, गायनी में ना गायनेकोलॉजिकल रोबोटिक सर्जरी करती हूँ, उसमें जो भी सर्जरी हम कर रहे हैं वो सारी एक ही डाटा बेस में जा रही है, वो इवन मेरे सेल में लाइक जितने भी केसेस मैंने किए अगर मैं टच करूंगी तो सारे खुद ही मेरे सेल में आते जाते हैं, उन्हीं का सिस्टम है। और पूरी दुनिया की सर्जरी जैसे एक ही जगह पे कलेक्ट होती है, दुनिया में जो भी गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट उस रोबोटिक सिस्टम
पे काम कर रहा है,
हाँ सेंट्रलाइज हो गया है, और रोबोट उसको एनालाइज करता रहता है आपकी सर्जरी, आपने क्या इक्विपमेंट यूज किया, कितने सेकंड्स के लिए कहां क्या किया, तो इसी से वो कह रहे हैं कि जी
पूरा डेटा उसमें है, एग्जैक्टली पूरा डेटा उसमें स्टोर रहता होगा, यू कैन शेयर इट,
के अलावा इंटरप्रिटेशन भी साथ ही साथ है, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इंटरप्रिटेशन भी आपकी
सर्जरी, तो मतलब हमें तो कुछ करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है फिर,
हां कल को वो कहते हैं इसी को तो टेक ओवर करके रोबोट खुद सर्जरी करेगा कि कहां क्या स्टेप किए गए इसकी एनालिसिस से ना,
हो रही है जी हो रही है बिल्कुल, वो जब वो पूरा इंटरप्रेट करके उनको यस और नो करके जिसमें डेटा फीड किया जाता है ना, एग्जैक्टली रोबोटिक सर्जरी हैज गॉट इट्स टेकन इट्स ग्राउंड नाउ,
हां
इट वाज ग्रेट हियरिंग फ्रॉम यू योर पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस, वाओ
हां डेविंसी का था उसमें नहीं था, ये भी सीएमआर का है ना यूके का, इसमें ये सारा सिस्टम है जो रिपोर्ट को सेल्फ उस पे लेके जा रहे हैं कि खुद करे लेटर ऑन 8 इयर्स 10 इयर्स बाद,
जी हां और आई थिंक एज दे क्लेम दैट दैट वुड बी मोर सेफ इवन because there would be way less chances of risk.
Thousands of surgeries jab ho jayenge to analysis bahut big ho jayega na ek single surgeon
ke liye, decision making ke liye uske paas itna data hoga ki if this happened that you have to do this, this happened that you have to do this, that's we call techno human collaboration, so wow great, so we have like you know great audience today mashallah, to aapka to real hand aur ye practice already aapko being through this, so I'm going to learn from you, great great knowing that, great hearing that, so thank if you allow me we have to get back to our next
yes quiz. Thank you,
and this call has been chat box, right, so that we can later on just take this record from the chat box and it's gonna be part of your formative assessment, and you know formative assessment hoti hai, summative assessment hoti hai, you all must know it, so yes, or formative ka ek jo hai na part hota hai immediate feedback, that we are also trying to provide now, because without feedback I don't think that the formative assessment is going to be valid one, so to make it more reliable and valid we have to keep giving you feedback, so if you all have done your answers for this three yes, questions sir. I'm gonna show you what lies beneath, so good luck to them who has taken option as yes, and let me give you some evidence from the literature, we hum jo bhi bolte hain uske liye kuch na kuch reference kuch evidence hona zaruri hai, so this particular study done by Aronsi in 2022 their aim was to examine the perceptions of youth and learners on the use of TEL, and after a thorough investigation that particular paper or those authors actually they concluded that the teachers perceived that the use of TEL platforms was an efficient approach. So they also mentioned another interesting point. That point is also backing the answer in question number 5. So I'm not telling you because you already have mentioned your answer. So I hope you will not change your answer after listening this. That they also mentioned TEL was perceived to enhance language learning, and they perceived the use of technology for educational purpose was also difficult. So the only explanation उन्होंने क्या provide की थी कि I mean for this particular phenomenon कि उनको difficulty क्यों हुई थी कुछ participant को, it was the empirical evidence that inside reporting on the need of learners and teachers level of digital literacy skills. वो हमेशा जो है ना दो group रहेंगे, हर field में होते हैं, TEL में भी रहेंगे, तो there will be participant who will be conversant, very adept, very expert. At the same time, there will be like, you know, intermediate kind of students and learners, and those also would be lagging behind. But there are particular reasons that why did they lag behind. And if somebody can really usko target kar lega na, agar unki jo capacity building pe work karke, need assessment pe work karke, ke what were the reasons for them to lag behind, then again, they can, you know, catch up. So this is a good sign, actually. So nothing to worry about. So now, for those who have done yes for question number 5, again, congratulations. And we are providing you with some evidence. There's lots of paper published in agreement with the same notion, but I have taken this, something that was like more prominent and more recent one. For this particular paper being done by Purnama, they have done it in 2021, and their main objective was to determine who main factors which can affect digital literacy and related online risks. So lagging behind alone is not a problem. That's not a problem. He can, you know, being brought up and like, you know, being helped, being supported, being encouraged. But it's not also very simple. As if you are not aware how to handle the new technology, it's not very simple. It doesn't mean that you will be only failing and getting benefits from that particular tool or device or app or resources. That is for TEL. अगर आपको नहीं आती तो आप वो यूज नहीं कर सकेंगे. सिर्फ एक यही इसका प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. प्रॉब्लम ये है कि एनी हाउ यू हैव टू गेट इंडल्ज ड्यू टू पीयर प्रेशर, ड्यू टू योर नीड्स, प्रॉब्ली ड्यू टू योर लर्निंग नीड्स. आपको इन्वॉल्व होना पड़ता है ऐसे बहुत से डिवाइसेस को यूज करने में, एप्स को यूज करने में, रिसोर्सेज को. अगर आप उसमें एक्सपर्टीज नहीं डेवलप कर रहे, इफ यू आर नॉट टेकिंग गाइडेंस फ्रॉम द सीनियर्स, और इफ यू आर नॉट स्टिल कन्वर्सेंट, सो इफ यू आर नॉट मच एफिशिएंट इन डीलिंग विद द यूजेबिलिटी, so anyone like he or she might fall a prey in the hands of cyber security issues, cyber theft issues. You know, there are many apps which are not legit. Wo to banayi is purpose ke liye gayi hai ki they would simply ask you for your credit card details, or sometimes they may ask many things about your personal life. So this all puts you at risk. So being lagging behind is a small problem, but keeping yourself at that position is a larger harm you are going to put yourself into. Similarly, these authors that we just mentioned in question number five, they have concluded that, and what did they say? They say that their findings confirm that digital literacy can affect online risk in cyber world. So moving on to question number 3 again. So a big congratulations for those fellows who have taken the answer as yes. किसी ने इस पे no किया था क्या? और not sure किया था किसी ने?
Not sure मैंने किया था
sir. अच्छा, not sure, you are playing safe. ये भी ठीक है.
नहीं sir, मैंने उसको reason लिखा आगे.
अच्छा ठीक है. That's I'm going to take from the record, inshallah. So when we have an improvement in the academic performance of students during the recent pandemics, because was attributed to an improved online learning environment. So what they have proved, they said that actually they have investigated how the medical school and all these institutes or the colleges, schools closures when they were shut down in 2020. So it has influenced the performance of of students in curriculum-based online learning. But what interesting, they found that the students' performance increased actually during the shutdown of school in 2020 relative to the year before. So 2019 में जो उन्होंने course के जो scores थे, grades थे, उसको जब comparison किया 2020 से, so they found that student performance was higher than before. And they also concluded that the online learning environment may be effective in such scenario actually. Another finding which I personally, अच्छा मुझे बड़ा वो समय ना एक वो striking finding एक और भी इसमें मिली paper में, आप भी पढ़िए guys, बड़ा दिलचस्प paper है. That particular finding was as author stated that low achieving students jinke grade hamesha kam aate the, they also have shown greater improvements in performance even than those students who were the high achieving students. So actually what they have suggested, the author suggested, that there has been narrowing of the gap in performance between low and high achieving students. Yes, if I will open the forum for discussion, so you also might raise some concerns ke, भाई हो सकता है वो क्रोपन बुक एग्जाम हो गए थे, हो सकता है कि वो एग्जाम वेन्यू वाज एट देयर होम, प्रोबब्ली दे माइट हैव जस्ट टेकन सम अनप्रोफेशनल अनएथिकल यूजेज ऑफ काइंड ऑफ टेकिंग हेल्प फ्रॉम द एल्डर्स फ्रॉम पीयर्स व्हाइल डूइंग द एग्जाम, देयर कुड बी मेनी अदर रीजंस. सो देयर हैज टू बी समथिंग मोर इंटेंसली बीइंग डन एज एन व्हाट यू कॉल दिस फ्यूचर वर्क बिल्ड अप ऑन this particular study. So वो जरा उसको control भी कर सके ना उन environment को भी अगर, तो I think then their answer would be more logical. I mean in my personal opinion. So
sir ये मैंने not sure इसलिए लिखा था कि no doubt इसका फायदा तो हुआ था, है फायदा है भी, लेकिन
reason probably factors कुछ और भी हो सकते थे.
हाँ जी बिल्कुल, हमने जो note किया था कुछ चीजों में ऐसे था, जिस तरह मैट्रिक एफएससी का आपने देखा था, उन लोगों को जो नहीं दे रहे थे एग्जाम उनको वो भी पास हुए, फिर कुछ लोग मेडिकल में भी ऐसे था कि सिंपथी के तौर पे भी लोगों ने कहा कि चले वे यार पास कर देते हैं, लीनियंट मार्क ही कर देते हैं इनकी इस बार, तो वो चीजें भी बीच में है, लेकिन नो डाउट इसका फायदा भी था.
आई एग्री
तो इसलिए मैंने नोट शोर लिखा था, नो नहीं किया, फायदा हुआ भी है लेकिन नोट मैंने इसलिए किया.
आई एग्री, क्योंकि होता है ना कि सारे हाइपोथेसिस को अगर वो करते जाते हैं, डील करते जाते हैं, तो और अपने ही जिस डायरेक्शन में उन्होंने स्टार्ट किया था एम के साथ, और वो प्रूव हो भी जाता है, तो बहरहाल वो तो काम होता है क्रिटिकली अप्रेस करने का. द रिव्यूअर्स व्हेन दे आर रिव्यूइंग दीस पेपर, दे मस्ट हैव जस्ट रेज्ड दीस कंसर्न्स, एंड प्रोबब्ली देयर हैव बीन सम इश्यूज व्हिच हैव बीन डेल्ट. सो एनीवे, बट दैट वाज अ फाइंडिंग. सो अगर हमें अब देखना है कि ट्रांजिशन हुआ है नहीं, जारी बात, इट्स स्टिल एन ऑनगोइंग प्रोसेस. सो ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम ट्रेडिशनल टू टीएल रिसोर्सेज, and it's very common among healthcare educators, और मैं खुद अपने कोलीग से ही सुनता रहता हूँ, वो जब भी बात करते हैं फ्लिप क्लासरूम रनिंग जो है एजेंडा उनके पास होता है, कि एंड दे अज्यूम दैट इट्स द मेन और द ओनली टीएल डोमेन. और हमारी कोई रिसर्च भी हुई है इस पर, फ्लिप क्लास पे पब्लिश हुई. तो मसला ये है कि हर आदमी अपने हिसाब से सोचता है, तो वो ये करते हैं कि ट्रांजिशन जो हुआ है, ये लेक्चर जो प्रिंटेड टेक्स्ट बुक थी उनसे हम डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म जो हमने आगे यूज किया है, एंड वी हैव जस्ट लैंडेड इन अ डोमेन ऑफ फ्लिप क्लासरूम. सो दिस इज द ओनली एंटिटी व्हिच इज देयर इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ टीएल. इट्स नॉट ट्रू एक्चुअली, नो, बिकॉज द फ्लिप क्लासरूम इज वन बट नॉट द ओनली प्लेटफॉर्म, इज नॉट द ओनली टीचिंग मॉडलिटी बींग रिलेटेड और बींग ऑगमेंटेड बाई टीएल. सो एज एजुकेटर्स स्ट्राइव, जब वो आगे जाते हैं ना, इंगेज करते हैं स्टूडेंट को इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ लर्निंग फॉर मोर डायरेक्टली विद एक्टिव लर्निंग. सो दिस मींस यू नीड टू इंक्लूड मोर इंटरएक्टिव एक्टिविटीज इन योर क्लासरूम. यू कैन आल्सो ड्रामेटिकली इंप्रूव योर स्टूडेंट परफॉर्मेंस बाय इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग इंटरएक्टिव एलिमेंट्स इनटू योर लेसन, व्हिच वी विल सी एंड डिस्कस एंड शेयर विद यू गाइस इन नेक्स्ट फ्यू स्लाइड्स. सो डिटेल एज ने क्या किया, रिवोल्यूशनाइज तो कर दिया. आई मीन एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ हैज बीन रिवोल्यूशनाइज्ड. And education is no different. So let's remember educational technology. What is it actually? It is the set of information and communication for resource, processes, tools. Those all could be applied to the structure or jitni bhi activities hai usme, for the educational system in its various fields and levels. So let's see the next slide. कितना उसमें जो है ना वो स्टेटमेंट को हम समझते हैं कि वो ट्रू है,